Hey everybody, it is Cinnamon Cooney, your Art Sherpa. You are in the live broadcast of Colorful Cow. If you're here on the replay, hi, I'm so glad you could come even later and join us. Today on the mic is my husband, John.
Hi guys, how you doing?
So he reads the comments, tracks the community, and also he's a Sherpa tracker. He follows me around with our cameras to make sure you have some idea what it is I'm doing when I'm teaching this painting. And that's what we do here. We're going to teach this painting today.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see if we get this tip because our lights are so bright. Look, it's like gone. It's back. It's gone. It's back. We're going to teach this painting today. I'm going to show you step by step. I'm going to paint a thing. You're going to paint a thing. I'm going to paint a thing. At the end, we're all going to have a wonderful painting. In the description, those little words, if you click the dot, 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 more, there's a whole bunch of information. There's a link to a traceable because I don't think drawing should be a barrier to painting. So we've got videos on how to trace. There's a lot of videos on how to transfer an image on to a canvas. And listen, there ain't no shame in that game. It's totally okay. It's totally okay. It's a skill you'll learn over time, but you don't need to have it today. Also in there is the Paint My Photo photo reference, if you want to see the original photograph that this came from.
Mm-hmm.
And should be the painting. A link to the painting so that you can pull that out or print it out and look at it as we're painting along.
Mm-hmm.
I'm working on a 16 by 20 canvas today that I've lightly sketched the image in, but I'm going to talk about how to draw it in and darken it up so you guys can really see it. And over here we have the palette of paint. There he goes. He's on the palette cam. I'm going to move some things around because I like to keep water out because I like to use water as a fluid medium with my acrylic paint, and you can do that. Today's colors are titanium white, phthalo green, cadmium red, phthalo blue, dioxazine purple, cad yellow medium, quinacridone magenta, and of course black. So I've got some fluid blacks. You could use our traditional Mars black. You know, just little inside kind of exchange tip on this particular cow. I give you my exact colors so that you can get the exact result I got. But of course, you could kind of mix it up, change it up, have a little bit of fun, because this is an abstract, colorful cow, and I didn't, you know, open up billboards across the country of the cow, but like, cows should look like this. So however you want to paint your cow, it's an acceptable, important cow. We want to see your cow when you're done on our social media,
mm-hmm.
on Facebook and Instagram. We love to see your guys' paintings. We love to hear from you. And when we hear from you, we like to do things called wishes.
Yes, we put wishes in the canvas.
We like to put wishes in the canvas to create good energy and good abundance in our arting community.
Mm-hmm.
And so we're going to do some wishes, and then we're going to get painting. All right, it's wish time.
It's wish time.
Wish time. Wish, wish, wish time.
We have a bunch of wishes in here.
We
so
do.
I don't think we're going to be able to get to all of them, but I want to just say thank you to the community. We have a lot of moderators out here helping us out today. I've seen Mona. I've seen... I saw Kim Sim.
Hi, Kim Sim.
I saw, let's see here. Who else is out there? I see Stephanie's out there today.
Awesome.
And there's Jane. So we got, I think, almost all of our moderators are here. Mark's up there.
They need to be here because so many of them have asked for this cow.
Yeah, I'm not.
The cow was a journey for me. It was an art journey. It took me a little while to get my head around this cow.
So they're all out helping us out today. And Bonnie's normally out there too. So I have to say thank you to all you guys out here helping us out. And thank you. We got a big crowd today. There's like 150 people here already.
Wow.
And it's still people coming in.
For cow.
So they're ready for the cow.
Yeah, I looked on YouTube. There's not a lot of cow tutorial, is there?
Mm-mm.
I was like, how should I frame my cow tutorial? And I was like, wow, there's not only not a lot of cow tutorial step by step, but there's definitely no, like the other really cool goofy guy, Mart.
Mm.
He's got a pop art space cow. Very
Ooh.
Different vibe, but it's a pop art space cow. It's
That's
big.
Cool. All right, so I'm going to throw some wishes in there. We have some wish for, so I saw Michelle and a couple other people had wished for good health and it was good health and so they can get away from the hospital and away from the pain.
Yes, I want you home and happy.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to put home and happy. You can put your wishes on the back of your canvas as well. I'm writing mine in with watercolor pencil in yellow so it disappears into the paint, which is why you just kind of have to believe that I'm writing these wishes.
Mm-hmm.
Because I got to paint over this. But if you want to do it in like indelible marker, you can always write wishes, meshes, or intentions on the back of your canvas.
Mm-hmm. And we had a wish for peace and well-being to the world.
Do you have the ones that I sent you?
Yeah, that's where I was coming up the other day.
Okay. Yeah, no more drive-bys.
Yeah.
That's silly. We could stop that.
That's yeah.
Yeah, that doesn't solve nothing. All right.
And Ellie, six, who's 6 months.
Ellie, six-month-old Ellie. We would like her to be off her ventilator today and just recovering, getting healthy and strong.
Mm-hmm. We had a secret wish.
Yeah. We have a secret wish for a friend of ours to start feeling some well-being and relief, especially in the leg area. Just full recovery.
Yeah. We also have a broken leg out there in the community that needs to be held. I think I saw Lori.
Okay. Well, then Lori, you too, man. Yeah. You're in the leg energy wish.
Yeah. You need some. Let's heal those legs.
Heal the legs. Let's send some good energy into the legs. I like my legs. I want your legs to be good, too.
And the epidural? Let's see here.
Yes, we have somebody who's, like, praying that their epidural is working.
I think that's a common wish there at that point.
No, actually, this is for Parkinson's.
Oh.
And I want to say, if you're suffering Parkinson's, painting is an incredible therapy for that. I did a bunch of reading on painting with Parkinson's, and it turns out, for many people, and obviously not all people because everybody's a unique snowflake, but for many, many snowflakes, it helps with the shaking and some of the pain and some of the symptoms of Parkinson's. So if
I had
you,
no idea.
Yeah, I didn't either. I was like, let's just get that painting out there.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. All right. So you know what? Of course, I forgot my
And there's a flood of more wishes coming in here, and I see some. I see some. We have some little brushes with us.
Mm-hmm.
So Genesis says hi.
Hi, Genesis.
And so I, you know, as I see more of those little brushes with us, I'll say hello. And but thank you for everyone for putting your wishes up there. I know that all of our light keepers will do their best to put those in the canvas so that, you know, we can get those wishes out there in the world.
And that is a great way to join the light-keeping community. If you see a wish and you feel like that energy needs to go into the universe, just add that wish to your own canvas.
Yeah.
You know, the world could use a little well-being thought about it, so we can add the light. All right, so I got Mr. Colorful. It's a girl cow. Mrs. Colorful Cow here.
Oh, yes.
And I looked at, oh, my gosh, you guys, you worked me so hard on this project. Because you guys have been asking a long time, really since Chicken, since the Judgy Rooster, that there be a colorful cow. And so I've been doing research, and you guys kept sending me the same two paintings. And I love both of those artists. We've already covered how to paint in the style of one artist, right? Like that kind of technique.
Mm-hmm.
And then the other artist, you know, kind of had this great abstract stuff. But I wanted to do something that was really original because, of course, it's important, especially for what I'm doing, to be original. So looked at photos on Paint My Photo. Like, there's a lot of cows. There's like thousands. Until I found the cow. It was like the pebble. Just looking for the cow. John knows I was just looking for the right cow. It was like a model search. It was like a crazy model search until I found her. Because I kind of had an idea of the design and style I wanted to do with her. But I had to find the right cow and the right picture. And I have such gratitude for this picture. This photographer probably has no idea the relief and cheering I had when I found her.
Mm-hmm.
She's like, maybe she felt a disturbance in the forest. She was like, wow, well-being is coming my way. So I'm going to show you how to draw this sweet, colorful cow in.
You want to zoom in on that? While you're doing that, I know that the color's a little off on that one. It has to do with the white paper or the white balance in here.
Yeah.
But
John may come fix that. I'm going to try to draw this. Don't draw this darkly on your canvas. I'm doing that so you can see it. How I'm drawing it in for those of you that are ready to draw it in. If you're not ready to draw it in, that's what the traceable is for. Fabulous thing to do. Remember, we have a video on how to get that on your canvas. So here's the center point of my canvas. About 2 inches down, I'm going to make a mark.
We'll give a little shout out here to David, who's a little brush with us.
Hi, David. Are you going to draw this in with us? I hope you do. So we're going to make a small mountain. Can you see this, John?
Uh-huh, I can.
Okay, at the top. And then it dips in a little bit, like a little valley. And then we're going to come out. This is the temple. And what's nice is that these should mirror each other a little bit, because if you imagine the skull underneath here, it would. Then we're going to come out for the eye socket a little bit, make a line in, and come out another little bump for the eye socket. Let me know when I need to move down, babe.
We want to be symmetrical cow.
We want to be symmetrical cow. So you can kind of see what I pre-sketched in there. I freehanded this. there's a feather that just went in my nose. That was crazy.
You were attacked by a feather.
I was so attacked. So I'm going to put in this little teardrop shape for the eye and run a little socket, then under the lid, right? I'm going to come down here on the jaw and then curve in.
And now you're off.
And now I'm off. But I'm going to come down here and do the nose. You're going to see this nose go in. Now, it's interesting. I'm going to point out a couple structural things when we're doing a count. Can I got this? Do I have? I think I have this.
You got it.
All right. So the cow nose will be straight down from the center down to here. And it's going to be essentially this cool rectangle. That's something I really noticed about cow noses was this sort of cool bricky shape that they are. It makes them really kind of cute, kind of chibi. So if you draw in a little rectangle just a little bit bigger than your head will be, it'll help you get that little shape. You're going to come with a little curve out, little lip up, comes upwards. The little lip curves up, down, back in, little reverse smile, and then back out. Right? And we're going to come up to this eye socket here and bring this side of the head down. So lid, bring a line in, lid. Teardrop shape, lid, jowl comes down into the nose. All right, now we're going to zoom out a little bit so you can see it, but I'm going to use the eyeballs and the nose to center on each other. So I have this inside corner of the eye and this inside corner of the eye and this part of the nose and this part of the nose, which means I go dip, out, dip, and join up. That is the nose bone. Right. Cow ears are a hoot and a half. They really are. They're like a leaf that's attached with a tube. I think that's how they designed Shrek's ears, to be quite honest. So you make your little leaf shape and then just bring a line up to this part of the temple bump. Same thing over on the far side. Make a little leaf shape. Simple little shape. You can handle the leaf. Then up to the same point on the temple and a little curve in. And the last thing I've got to worry about is right here at the top, at the where it starts to curve in on the skull, bring his little neck up. And then way down here at the corner of the lip to the bottom of the canvas, bring a little line down. And then under his little, and I'll even take this down so you can see it close, but I think you've got it once you have all this in. He just has this really diminished little lip, and it mirrors, it's smaller, almost like a full inch in this, comes underneath this, and then these weird, I don't know, tadpole shapes for the nose is almost what it is. Mm-hmm. These little teardroppy tadpole shapes. So that's really all it is to get this cow sketched in. You know, you can make little lines, tell yourself stuff about what's here. And I'm using watercolor pencil, like I always do, to make sure it disappears when I paint in the painting.
Yeah.
How easy was that? Super easy.
Seems pretty straightforward.
It's pretty straightforward. And you feel like, wow, I'm not really, that was crazy. That was like Greek. I don't know. That's what traceables are for. Mm. No shame in the traceable game.
Well, I don't know if you recall, we have a Papuska who's one of our community members. She's Michelle in San Diego. Mm-hmm. So I guess her boyfriend, Ewan, it's his birthday.
Hi, Ewan.
Some significant person in their life. So they watch and paint together, and it's his birthday.
Happy birthday.
So.
I just want to say, Ewan McGregor is good. It's just every time. Awesome name.
That's awesome.
It is. It's super awesome. I'm going to grab, I have Simply Simmons. If you've been traveling along with me the whole journey, you know Simply Simmons came into my life recently and I'm really liking them. I got a whole collection from the company, but these are just like, honestly, I just genuinely like them. I'm not getting anything to say it. I'm just telling you because they've been great. You guys that have bought them have loved them. Wholly recommend it. This is a number 12 Bright.
Ewan is 7, so I guess.
Ewan is 7.
So not boyfriend.
Not a boyfriend. Hi, Ewan. That's weird. Tell Johnny's weird. Well, You're so weird.
I was given no pertaining. We have a lot of husband
this
wives.
This is what it's like on YouTube, Ewan.
Yeah, just.
Okay. All right. And then also now I'm questioning how John said your name.
Ewan?
Ewan. Maybe, yeah. All right, so we've got this here. If you've been having trouble finding it, I've heard sightings are at the Brush Guys and at Office Depot. Mm-hmm. Under $5, three most places, and for all the brushes, all the sizes.
Yeah. I must
firm filament, guys. Get the firm filaments in your brushes. I'm going to take a little of my yellow paint. John's going to tell me a joke in a second. I'm going to take a little of my yellow paint over my white. And I'm going to have a bright yellow, but I'm going to, you know, cream it out a little bit into a duckling color and paint everything around the cow's head, all this outside space. Now you can tell me. What's going on, John?
So it's Ewan.
Ewan.
Yeah.
Oh, well, thank you.
I was close.
You were close. I mean, seriously, for how long it took us to do quinacridone.
A passamaquoddy?
Yeah, it went really well. So I'm just painting this in with this ducky, ducky yellow. This was a crazy decision. I really wrestled with going with the bright yellow.
I like it. It's very poppy.
You know what? I was like, every cow I'm looking at has the same soft blue sky.
Mm-hmm.
And I want my cow to be like standing in sunlight.
Now, to get the best coverage, or what yellow do you think you should be using?
Well, do you mean like what brand of paint or what color yellow?
Well, the question as it was posed to me was, what's the best yellow to get more coverage? So I would guess that's maybe orienting towards professional versus...
Yeah, so what it is yellow is one of those colors that in student grade can be more problematic. Sometimes they don't load it with enough pigment.
Yeah.
It gets very translucent or see-through. So that can just be frustrating for you as a new artist. I've had great success with Golden and Liquitex and Matisse.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, hey, Windsor Newton makes really good paint, Gallery Acrylics. There's some really good paints in different grades. And what it really is about is working your sales. Work your sales.
Definitely.
We work our sales.
Yes.
And also just, you know, buy the best paint that your budget can handle, right? So don't hurt your budget. Don't ever do that. That takes all the joy out of painting.
Yeah.
But, you know, for what your budget is, upgrade your paint to the degree that you can. It will make a difference.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to be testing some of the System 3, I think, soon. And I'm hopeful. Because it would be very nice to have a paint that was the equivalent of these economic brushes that are so good.
Yeah.
Because I have spent a lot of money on brushes and not had brushes be this good. I'm actually pretty happy. It's been a delight. Not to speak too strongly, but I'm going to use the word delight.
Well, I have to say, I think they're pretty cool myself.
Yeah, you've touched them. They're just, yeah. It's just a whole difference. And, you know, I'm not mad at creative work or nothing. Nobody's mad. But, you know, the sale's only like twice a year, and it's really dependent on that sale.
Now, if you're having trouble getting the traceable, how would we do that? Where would be the best way to get that?
To get the traceable?
Mm-hmm.
So today I put the traceable in two places. I put it both on my Facebook personal page, on the Heart Party page, and so you can grab it there, download it, and print it. And I also, in the link, there's a link to the traceable on Pinterest. It got put in about 5 minutes before the show. So that's where it is. There's actually, I just put the link to the whole traceable board on Pinterest.
Ah, cool. Very cool.
So that's all they need to do, and they should be able to find it. You're going to notice that you're going through quite a lot of white paint to do this duck yellow sky. Could you do a blue and white sky? Yes, you could. You could do green and white. You could do a bright red sky. A lot of skies you could do. My mom thought it'd be nice to do a black sky.
Hmm.
But I really like this yellow. It just, like, when I was designing, I was like, it needs to be yellow. I swear, I heard a voice. It was like... What Dreams May Come kind of voice, or the Field of Dreams voice. That's it. The Field of Dreams voice came and told me to paint my cow yellow.
Really?
Yeah. I mean, just it was really compelled. Hmm. Every once in a while that happened to you as an artist, you'll be like trekking along, minding your own business, when you're like, I feel drawn to this. So this is just a number 12 bright doing this. And look, that went in about 2 seconds.
More requests for abstract flower tutorials.
Okay, more abstract flowers. Absolutely, they're fun.
Well, actually, Zelda, and I'm pretty sure I spelled it, said that one right, was saying that she would like to see, please do a tutorial on flowers again.
Oh, so, I love doing flowers.
I think we probably should do some more flowers.
I love doing these, so I'm going to keep going. I mean, like, we love it. We love it. We love sharing the art with you guys. We do. And as long as you guys want it, we're happy here to be here and share it.
Mm-hmm.
There's Goldilocks. Yeah. Like, I still look for this one, though. It's like I trust her more. It's so weird. Now, I'm going to make a really interesting background color and put a little more white. You could make some green and add it to your blue. You can do a bunch of different turquoise mixes, but this is a fun one I haven't shown you before. I'm going to take a little of my phthalo green over to my phthalo blue. You know, could your Southern Ocean blue work here? Yes. Could your aqua work here? Yes. But I'm going to do these two because it makes a very interesting color. I'm going to take a small amount of it over, add it to the white until I get this almost aquamarine color. That's almost a little too dark. I'm going to, there we go, add a little white to it. And I'm going to paint all of the neck around the ear and everything in this color first. Now, so even though this is abstract, it still has layers.
Does it matter which shade of phthalo green you use, whether it's yellow or blue? Yellow or blue?
This phthalo blue is blue shade. And if it were yellow shade, you would get a slightly different tone or tint. It would just impact it. For this painting, because it's so pop art, because it's so abstract, you know, we're not doing atmospheric perspective. We are doing some color theory here. We're having some fun with some different things. But mm-hmm. we're just mostly painting us a cow.
Yeah.
In colorful colors. Which there's not enough out on the internet. I can see where you guys were like, I need a colorful cow.
There's a great request in here that I think that would go right along with some of your recent thinkings too.
Oh, what?
And for some of the Egyptian gods.
Oh, for the especially that new movie coming out.
Doesn't that look good?
Yeah, it really does.
Yeah.
And we all dork it up right now.
So Joy just got here. Joy, you missed everything. You're going to have to use the DVR function, rewind, go back.
Hi, Joy. Don't let John give you any grief. If you're playing on the replay, we haven't lost our minds. There really are people in the room we're not imagining. And I hope you can show up on one of our live events and join Joy. So you can, too, be ribbed when you come in late.
Yep.
Like we have a roll call. Where was Joy? Joy's at home going, oh, my God, stop.
Don't show up late for the cow painting, Joy.
You know he's kidding. Just so you know, he's totally kidding. That's not even a true thing. It does not even matter even a little bit.
Nope, that's why that it's recorded live here on YouTube forever.
Forever. Well, you know, as long as the stream is good.
Yeah, for as long as the
stream is good.
And the YouTube decides to host colorful cow paintings.
And YouTube, but they seem very supportive.
They do.
We've talked to them. I have a wonderful mentor.
Yeah, they even give us like customized tech support for it for their free service.
I know. I was just like, thank you for your free service that you're now helping me use better for free.
And make money on.
You guys are amazing. Yay. I think I feel a little bit about you, like about YouTube the way you guys feel about me.
Yeah.
I'm just so grateful to them. So in acrylic painting, one of our tricks is just trying to get the paint to cover the canvas, right? And if we're buying an expensive canvas like I am, I get the 5-pack from Michaels.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I don't do that on my fine art, but, you know, for the daily lessons I do.
Sorry, had to have some kids.
We have kids.
We have kids.
We got threes of them. They are cute, but trouble. They're cute, but trouble. So we have this in right here. Now I feel like I need another little sippy break. I need to coffee it up. But coffee. That's looking really good. Aren't these colors in balance of each other just really like, whoa? It's messing with my camera, I can tell.
I think it looks good.
My camera's like, what's happening? I don't like it. I don't get it. I don't get it. This is the camera's like, I don't get it. What's happening? Don't get it.
Don't understand.
Ooh, I got vanilla. Coffee today with vanilla soy, and it's super sippy sippy, and we're all gonna send Bunny light and love wherever she is.
Yes, and sippy sippy to all of the community with us. And I want to say thank you again to everyone who's out there, because mm-hmm. we're over 200, like we're around 220 right now.
Wow.
Okay, thank you guys.
Thank you.
And we're having a great time in chat. You know,
I'm switching to a number 4 brush while John's being grateful.
Number four
bright.
Bright.
And number 4 bright. I'm really loving these brights so much. And I'm just using straight phthalo blue in this ear. And you're like, are you really? I'm like, yeah. Because I'm creating an underpainting.
Speaking of
believe it or not, not every cow painting I tried to design even came out. There was a bunch that did not make it. They're going to see some gesso.
So I know you're going to want to say hello. Lindsay just came in.
Oh, hi, Lindsay.
You'll have to tell her later.
What?
All your crazy ideas.
Well, my crazy ideas. Well, I'll tell you what my last crazy idea was. She gave this really good tip for the last painting that I really wish I had. We have to go by Harbor Freight. Apparently, there's a tool to get that frisket off with. You can get it at Harbor Freight.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. And so I annotated it into the video.
Is it an electric eraser?
No. It's a rubber cement remover.
Oh.
It saves your hands. My fingers were all bit up, to say the least. To say the least, guys, my fingers were bit up. Isn't that crazy?
Yeah, I came over there and just did it a little bit, and my fingers were messed up.
Yeah.
So Erica was asking, what's the difference between acrylic level 1 and 2 paints?
Okay. So according to the companies, and I do try to talk to the chemist directly and really also get this out of the paint manufacturer's mouth, what your basic differences are, you're still not going to see a true cadmium pigment at a level 2 paint, but they will improve the quality of the ingredients. So there'll be a deeper pigment load than in a student paint, and the polymers will be more stable and less likely to underbind, and it will just perform a little bit better for you.
Yeah.
So it literally is what it seems to be. If you go student paint, which has a much lighter pigment load, and they, you know, a polymer, I mean, how many times have you guys been varnishing? If you do a brush varnish on some of the student paints and, like, the paints didn't, it slipped.
Yeah.
It smeared. It happens. Not every tube, not every time, but it's like a random lottery you don't want to win. The mid-grade paints won't do that at all. And then the pro paints, you can pretty much break all the paint rules with and be okay. Huh?
So it sounds like that may have helped a couple people out there.
I hope so. We have a really fun paint-to-paint review that we did. Don't take it too seriously, but we had a lot of fun making it. And I'm going to come over and put my brush into my green here, this phthalo green. And I'm going to get a little of my bright yellow. I'm going to get this sort of bright color here. And I'm going to just paint this little spot right here. So we're getting this underpainting of the cow blocked in.
Hey, I think I see the crafty twins in there, too.
Oh, how are the girls?
Well, more little brushes.
Hi, girls. Got to check out the crafty twins channel. It's a really cool channel. I have a video response that I've got to do for them, but thanks to your mom, I can now face the frisket.
So, Monica.
I was like, oh, no, I don't want to deal with the frisket tomorrow.
So if I'm reading this right here, Monica has 10 little girls in the room with her looking at the TV screaming, crazy cow.
Is it a crazy cow? Hi, little girls screaming, crazy cow. Hi. Yeah, it is live. That's so funny. Well, I hope they're all enjoying doing a crazy cow and they're thinking about how they can make their cow crazy. Because there's nothing as fun as a crazy cow. Right?
Mm-hmm.
I almost went to my coffee. You know how that is with me. You know how it is.
Yeah. So,
I'm going to do blue underneath here and a dark blue again underneath here.
So, you remember Joy who showed up a little late here?
Oh, yeah.
She has a question.
I'm surprised she's still speaking to us.
Well, you know, we covered this one earlier, but we'll cover it again for
her.
So John,
you're just punchy today.
So she is just kidding.
Just so you know, Joy, he's in no way being serious. People have different temperaments, babe. So let people know you're joking.
So she has a painting that she didn't like. It was one of those bad paintings, and
it happens to me. I could show you my bad gal.
And she painted over it white.
Good for you.
And now that it's painted over, is it? Is that okay? Can she just paint over that again now?
You know, if the color isn't seeping through and it looks like the paint has sealed it, it should be fine. The only reason you ever worry, gesso is just less expensive than your good white paint.
Mm-hmm.
And it's chalky and it gives you a nice surface and it can give you a good sealant. But I won't lie to you. I've used just white paint and painted over it and had no trouble ever. It's completely allowed. It's only a problem if it starts seeping through.
Okay.
So I'm just getting this nice dark color here. What I'm trying to do is just create these little fields, these little zones.
Yeah.
Like you do. And it's super fun. This is like super relaxing style of painting, in my opinion. The colors and the layers and, you know, how you create these quadrants that, you know, you then address.
The blocks of color.
Blocks of color. It makes it fun, I think.
I do, too. I like the blocks of colors. It was really fun. Your painting inspired my intro making this morning.
It did. I was like, John's feeling very artistic today.
Well, I had all these awesome, you know, color grading tools. So I was like, I can pop art this up.
Now, I think Tuesday night, and Lindsay will have to confirm over on her channel, I and another friend of her, Marty, we're going to be doing Ask a Painter.
Ooh.
She might be changing her schedule, so I'm soft pitching this. So if she's here, she can confirm if that's true. I'm softly saying it.
Oh. Well, she's here hanging out.
Okay, so she'll know if it's for sure, for sure.
Yeah. Mona was just giving us a woohoo. We got 237 people in here right now.
Let's do the 237 people dance.
Woohoo!
It's
Thank
now
you
officially our 237 people dance. 777. I don't know. All right, I'm
gonna find
a little
some music in a minute here if you're not careful.
And I will dance to it, Mr.
I'll
Cooney.
Make you dance.
Dance artist dance. So I've taken a little of my phthalo blue over to my cad red. And the wonderful thing about these two paints is that they make this great brick color, but it gives me a nice base to come under here. Now, yes, the color on him is going to be really bright in a minute, but this dark base will actually make the cad red look even brighter. Weird side effect.
You know, see, the thing is that I have all sorts of good music, though.
You do? What do you got? No thumbing me down for bad dancing. Don't you do it.
Rose thinks the cow needs a nose ring.
The cow could totally have a nose ring. I didn't really give him a lot of nose ring room, but go for it.
You could put a crazy hat on the crazy cow.
You could. I almost did the tags, and I couldn't decide artistically if I wanted to do tags or not. You know how you get in there and you get in the design, you're like, to tag or not to tag the cow? And then I just decided I didn't want to really, you know, open up that whole can of worms of, like, you know, tagging or not tagging cows.
Uh-huh.
But, like,
tagging cows.
Well, he had little tags in the ears, you know?
Free cows.
Free cow.
No tags here.
Do you remember when we were traveling across country? I don't remember what van. And we were like in the desert and there were like all these signs of cows, but like,
oh, that
like
was
the cow artist was like losing his mind wherever he was.
Yeah, that was, there were some crazy cow drawings.
There
and you get out in West Texas and there's some really crazy cow
there's
drawings.
There's some really bizarre cow signs. Like, cause at first there's like, you know, static, stoic, I'm sorry, I'm taking you on a ride here. Static, stoic cow, you know, it was like static and beautifully drawn. And then there was like jaunty cow.
Yeah.
Like the little tail is up and it's like sort of like.
It's like this cow could jump out in front of you.
And wasn't there like a cow that looked like it was dead?
Yeah.
It was like dead cow.
It was like a swerving car or something.
There was a swerving car with a cow being hit and little like lines saying this cow is. It was crazy.
There's some crazy cow signs out there, guys.
There is some crazy, crazy cow signs out there.
Crazy.
I'm going to just do a little bit. I've added a little more red to it, but I'm going to take this under here. So it's a slightly different value. There, oh good, it's in a good space. You know, but it will definitely give my bright, pure pigments a pop. A very sweet artist that I'm a huge fan of and a collector of, Terry Crumb. Crump, not Crumb. Totally different artist.
We got a couple of his paintings now, don't we?
Yeah, we're trying to get a couple.
Yeah.
He did pears, though. I feel like I should get the pears. Unbeknownst to, like, all of us, he just did some pears. It just cracked me up so much. He paints entirely out of the tube, which is really interesting
real
to see him do.
Real pure colors.
Yeah, real pure pigments right out of the tube, and then finishes them off sometimes with a Sharpie, which is a really interesting choice. I'm just taking the Dioxazine Purple. I feel like I need to, like... Sorry.
She's just going kind of crazy there today.
I don't know. It's a good... You know what? It's a good Saturday.
It is a good Saturday. It's
such a good Saturday, right?
There you go. I'll give you a lower third. It's worthy of your little redneckness.
I'm telling you, somebody would two-step with me. Maybe not you, but somebody would
two-step
with me.
I don't know how to two-step.
It's two steps, John.
Well, see, that's one too many. I got one step. It's a button push. See, look. One, two, three. One, two.
Oh, you are...
One.
You are so bad. Such a goofball.
I got buttons to push. That's what I can do.
You've got buttons to push, and that's what you can do?
Yep.
I'm going to kind of... take my brushes into some cleaner paint. On really bright paintings like this, I recommend you change the water often so you can keep your paint pure. I'm sure I'm going to be sending John out for paint in a second anyways. Sometimes you send your husband out for like errands. Mine's like, I need clean water.
Water. And see, notice how dangerously close her old water dish is to her coffee there.
Oh, it is a problem, isn't it? I'm gonna sippy sippy. This is just coffee, just so y'all know. I'm just caffeinated. I think on some of us YouTubers, it's more obvious when we're caffeinated. Like, I feel like, not calling out Lindsay, but I'm just saying, like, some of us, when we're caffeinated, you can totally tell that we're completely caffeinated and we're really, really going.
Like you.
Yeah. We, like, lose our mellow. I'm doing a 1-1 mixture, so an even dab of the blue and the green. You're so funny. And I'm going to pull the white into it. And I'm going to paint in the rest of this head here in this slightly greener, slightly darker color range. And that, except for the eyes, should seal up my canvas with the paint, giving me... a beautiful surface. And what's wonderful about that, it allows me to have very expressive loose brush strokes, thick paint, and not worry about the white of the canvas showing through. That's not the worst thing that has ever happened to anyone, white of the canvas showing through, but you've got to be really, really, really together at what you do before you let the white of your canvas show. It's a weird deal.
So Monica says the girls were all dancing with you. They loved it.
Good for you. We're all having the crazy cow day.
And Crafty Twins say that their mom is always caffeinated.
You know what? It's because we're moms and we need to be.
Ooh, Kim J got me a cow emoticon in there.
How do they do that?
Thank you, Kim. That was awesome. I like the emoticons.
I love me some gifts on Facebook. Oh, you know what the worst is, though? When you misgift somebody. So the other day, I'm talking with Clive from Clive 5. Because we've got a thing coming up we're going to do. And I'm thinking, oh, I'm going to send a funny glitter gift to him. And there was this one of this guy going, glitter. So I clicked it, but the one above it went, and it was like psycho. It was like some crazy girl going, when I don't have glitter, I eat placenta. And I'm like, oh, my God.
Oops, wrong gift.
I don't even know how to explain that.
Oh, look. Lots of cow gifts are coming up now. We have a little cow and cow head. Oh, that's so cute.
I have these like little artsy fartsy moments.
They're doing it on their phone.
Yeah. And I think some of them buy like extra.
Oh, there's like a bull cow there too.
Wow.
Janine has one.
Is he a jaunty bull cow?
Yeah, it is. He's a jaunty bull.
I'm just saying, somebody up at the sign company was having a day.
Yeah. Rose says, you'll never steer us wrong.
Oh, Rose, good for you. Yeah, always go for the pandemonium.
We're in for it.
So you can see this just has a slightly greener tone to it. And it's a little, you know, darker than this, and, you know, we're creating these values in the space. It's not that important how you paint it in, like, on brushstroke directionality. You just want this coat of paint.
Ooh, a blue cow. I think it's a cow.
Where?
I don't know. In the emoticons.
Well, I can't see that because my comments have been taken away.
That's right. They were you were taken away.
You know, I was getting comments on my reading comments.
You were.
People were like, "I love you, but you got
to
stop."
And so, if anyone would like to know, I'm going to have to find out what episode it was. We had it in there because you stopped and were like, "Look, reading the screens," and I was like, "You just stop it." But take it away from you, and I did the next time.
I did. He's like, you can't read your own comments. This is really to do these lives whenever you see us out here, any of us out here doing these lives. It's a two-person deal. It takes you and a friend or a spouse or some other, you know, person who's willing to do this with you. So I have that in, and I'm going to put this in water. I'm going to put out a little bit of my black. Now, I used a fluid black, but you could use the Mars black that you already have in your kit, or you can get some fluid black. The difference between the fluid paint and the heavy body paint is that you can see this kind of is like a plop of liquid, whereas this is a nice stiff little peak.
Yeah.
That's the difference.
Like liquid paint versus like almost icing.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, this is ganache, and this is buttercream.
Oh, yeah.
I just thought of that right now, so I'm not like premeditatively clever. That just came out. So I'm just going to paint this in very carefully, try to make sure I have a nice shape here. It's actually very little work to turn these big, black, beautiful eyes into something gorgeous to look at.
Lindsay says she has too many teenagers at her house maxing out the internet. She's eating black screens. I totally feel your pain.
Oh, we've got one coming into that range, and my daughter has friends now, and they come in packs.
Yeah, we now have two internets, one in the back, it's business class, and one in the front, that's for the kids and the rest of the people.
It was the only solution because the kids were going to win.
Yeah. And, you know, we're trying to get a solid 10 megabit pipe up so we can send all this streaming service out to you guys. So we brought in the business class service back here. And it's been pretty good for us so far.
We basically learned from YouTube that it's not them, it is us.
Yeah.
They were like, with love, it's not us.
Yeah.
We're all geniuses.
And they are.
Because they are.
They are.
They are. They're like, no. The internet speaks to us through our brains. Totally finds you. And so we looked and it was us and we were like, whoa.
We gotta fix it. So we've been going about fixing it. What are you sipping?
Coffee, but I'm feeling like it's low.
I can go get you more coffee.
Probably need a fresh cup of water too.
Yeah. Uh-huh. More water, more coffee. Uh-huh. We can do that.
Uh-huh.
Okay.
So I'm sorry.
No, it's right.
I know these like live things.
It's live.
I can edit this out later because up to 2 hours on a live event, you can edit. Not after two. You got to live with it.
No, we're doing pretty good. So you go ahead. What are you going to do next?
I'm going to let this dry.
Okay.
So I'll hair dry it while you give me coffee.
No, I'm going to talk to them while you hair dry it.
Okay, I'll talk to them. Do you want to talk to them?
You talk to them. I'll go get your coffee.
You want to dry it, stunt hands? Handsome stunt hands that he has.
No.
What are you doing?
Your coffee.
See, he's just not focused because he's got these drones now. I don't know. Have you guys seen all these drones? There's this show, Flight Test, and it sucks you in. My collabs? I have so many collabs. He's like, tell them about your collabs. I'm like, I don't know. I can't even track all of them. Well, you heard that I'm going to be on Ask a Painter with Lindsay. And I've got a thing coming up with Angela Anderson. She's going to paint The Kiss by Clint, and I'm going to actually torture you all with Le Belle Dame Merci by Dickesey from the pre-Raphaelite movement because I thought, why not just kidnap you all for hours on end? But it's actually teachable and I have shown people how to paint it before. So
how long do you think it'll take that to dry? Is it dry now?
No, I'm still just dry it.
Okay, go ahead and dry it.
Can I dry it?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'll just quiet you down for a minute while you're doing that. Her coffee is making in the other room. I just want to make sure that, you know, we keep this going for you guys. I know that we do full-length painting lessons here, and we really appreciate you guys all hanging out with us. And, oh, my gosh, we've got 240-plus people, like 243, 244. Wow. Thank you all for coming, and thank all of our moderators for being here. I really appreciate all of your help. It makes such a big difference. You know, it's so hard to be able to push all the buttons and read the comments and make sure I get cinnamon coffee. You know, so while we're managing all of this, I appreciate you guys bearing with me.
Thank you.
And so there she is. She's back.
I'm back. And I'm going to get a number 8. It's extra firm film. I'm loving these brushes. I have to tell you.
I actually, you know, I'll...
Brilliant.
I like them too. I have lots of nice things to say, but I'm going to wait until we've got about a month worth of use in them before I...
Yeah, he's waiting to see if they live because he's seen what has happened to them. He's like, are they in the water again? I'm like, look at their kids.
See that right there? That's how they live, right there. I walk in, that's where they're at.
I clean them well, but then somebody screams and is like, you took my Barbie! And then who knows what happens. Yeah. I'm like back at 12 at night going, I got to wash my brushes. I don't know if anyone knows what that's like. But if you do, then you do. So I'm going to do a really cool thing here.
What are you going to do?
I'm going to take a little of my Cad Red over to my Dioxazine Purple.
Okay.
Just a little bit. Just to warm up this purple. I'm even going to grab a little bit of white, trying not to catch the yellow because that would be the contrast. It would gray it out a bit.
Yeah.
And I'm going to come along here, underneath here. And I'm going to put in this purple. I'm not going to take it all the way across. I'm going to be making some very... I'm going to slow down and not make random shapes like crazy. So you can kind of see what I'm doing. But, you know, when you actually do paint this, you get very expressive. So I'm going to come down underneath this jawline. This represents the shadow that is underneath on the neck of this beautiful creature. I'm still trying to get John to tell me how we can go live to paint the blue bonnets so I can take y'all live.
We're working on it.
To paint the blue bonnets. And also, I like have this plan to like get... I feel like I owe Lindsay some blue bonnet pictures. So she'd be like, I'm painting blue bonnets. So I'm not going to take this all the way to the neck. And I'm going to try to be kind of a little bit crazy with my brush stroke. Do you see how crazy I was there? I'm picking up more purple, so the red and purple is blending into the just purple. If you're having a little trouble getting it to paint over, that may be the fluidity of your paint. And I'm going to come along out here. This is my shadow here. Super fun stuff. Thank you. Oh, I can mix my own creamer. Careful of the CAD there. Little. All right, so I've got this nice little color here. It's a fun color, and we like it, and it's entertaining. And I'm going to do some purple here and some... Oh, Kahlua. Don't like, chill out. Have some Kahlua. Nah, I'm good. Later tonight, I Kahlua. Sometimes I add Kahlua to my coffee. But it's a little early on a Saturday. So I'm going to grab a little of my white, bring it over here to my purple, and I'm going to come under the eye. I'm going to make a little sort of outward thing, come along this nose area. Just the nose.
I guess my mic's on as I bang it.
Pull it out a little bit. Pull it out a little bit into this space. This is always fun. They'll all be a little different from each other every time you do it. You know, but then we're not copy machines and we're not trying to fool anyone up at Sothersby's. Sotheby's. Woo! That's embarrassing.
So how do you know where to paint light and shade?
So what I do, and somebody I think already clued into this because I noticed them on the chat, is I look for those values in a grayscale. So I take a picture that I want to paint and I take all the color information out of it and I pop the contrast, and I'm looking for at least 5 value differences, especially for a pop art piece.
Hmm.
And that's how I get it. I'm going to just wipe this off here because I can. And I'm going to rinse out my brush really, 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 really well. And actually, if you can, take the brush you're currently using to the sink,
mm-hmm.
or get a whole new brush, I would, because you want this next part to be very, very clear pigment.
Do I need to go to the
Didn't you get me new water?
It? No, not yet.
Okay.
I got you new coffee.
Got me new coffee. I'm not complaining, darling.
I don't know. Maybe I did get you new water. I just may have left it in the other room.
Uh-oh. Okay. So what I'm going to do is I have just the white. You can see the bead that I've loaded up. This is almost like how you'd load a palette knife, but you wouldn't get it all over your hand. And I'm very loosely over the top up here going to just sort of randomly run this white over him. Just the white. And it's just the white. So fun. Thank you. Just the white. Really love this part. I'm not going to take it too much past the ear because I've got a little pattern that I want to do here. And the next thing that I'm going to do is down the center here. I'm going to do the same sort of thing. I'm going to start layering up this white very haphazardly. We're going to be coming back with more and more colors. And it's in those layers of colors that we're going to start telling some very interesting stories about our fabulous little cow here. But I need to create those layers. This one's even going to be... It's interesting how often, like, the painting I get to do when I get to spend some time with it will be better than even my design painting. Because I have to break down and think about what I'm saying to you guys, which I love to do.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and I'm going to just make some little brush strokes coming down here. This is just the first little layer. So we've just put some white on here.
Mm-hmm.
Is he too... Can we see him?
Yeah, you can totally see
how that is there?
Yeah, you can totally see it.
There we go. So I'm going to grab a small kind of... Hey, this is a number 4, and I'd say this is about... It's under a half inch, but it's a little bigger than a quarter inch. And I'm going to load up my paint similar way I did the first one with the bead.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to do this the check over here. Let's see if I can show you this check. This check is kind of a big deal to the painting.
Yeah, I like the check a lot.
Check is kind of a big deal to the painting. So I'm going to come along and lay down these check shapes with my white paint.
Mm-hmm.
Filling in this space. Then come between the checks. This is actually just how you do this. You might need some more white paint. You use a lot of white paint on this particular piece.
Mm-hmm.
Dropping caps. But I'll find it again.
Dropping caps.
not the interesting kind.
Golden caps.
No, Liquitex. Good Liquitex cap. I got to go get it back. All right. So see how you just get that little pattern in there?
Yeah.
And the size of your check is really determined by the size of your brush. Your brush helps you work that check out. I hear my daughter singing. So see, I'm bringing that into there.
Yeah, that's really cool.
There we go. Now I'm going to come back with some other stuff. Now over here to the side of her, and I really hope you can see it, it's a subtle value change between the two. We're going to put the check from about here in the ear down to about here on the muzzle.
So, do you know why farmers use 3-legged stools?
Oh, are you really going to do this to me right now? You know I got like an 11-year-old.
Yeah.
No, okay. No, John, why do farmers use 3-legged stools?
Because the cow has the udder.
Oh, my goodness.
Well, they're telling cow jokes out there, so I figured.
Is this the cow jokes they're telling though?
No,
because I really trust Mona to have a better joke in her pocket.
I just thought
I know Kim Sim does.
Oh, no, I think we're all rating about the same there. They're all.
Are we all in this space?
We're all in that space.
It's that kind of day. Everyone else decided to go for the Kahlua in the coffee.
Well, Rose says that she's heard them all.
Yeah, I'm sure Rose has.
So.
And who's with the 10 kids? I'm sure she's heard every knock-knock joke. Twice. This morning.
Well, we've got 10. I know we've got at least 10 little girls out there, so.
So they're ready for the knock-knock
joke.
They were
waiting for my joke.
They were good for it?
They were good for it.
Yeah, well, then you should have had a whole bunch of cow jokes.
Yeah, see, Kristen thought it was utterly ridiculous.
Oh, Kristen. Now, as I'm coming, I'm going to start reducing. You crocheters will totally know what I mean. I'm going to drop some of the checks as I come down. I love using, like, other, like practices, like, terms. We're going to reduce. And all the crocheters are like, I get this. This is just an implied pattern that I'm making. And you can see it, and it's just nice. All right, and that's what you're doing. You're just making an implied pattern. And that gives some interest to your painting, especially out in this bright yellow space. It says, something was more thought out than maybe you thought. Look at that.
Perhaps.
Perhaps. Perhaps somebody thought about this cow. Perhaps somebody loves this cow. Well, probably, right?
Yeah.
Probably somebody loves this cow.
I think it looks like a loved cow.
It's a loved cow. She's a dairy cow, California. So I took some yellow and white.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to come underneath here, and I'm going to scrumble some of that around here.
I can't see you scrumbling.
Uh-oh.
You're off the page.
Not a real scrumble, kind of like a, there you go. I'm going to be working over here now. So just some yellow and white over here. And then maybe just a little bit of this. Just around. It's what we're doing. Oh, you know what I forgot to put out? It's my cat orange.
Oh,
I full on used it in the painting, too.
Well, you should grab some.
I should.
Or shall I grab some?
I'll when I get to it, I'll give people the options of using just a mix of cad yellow and cad red. And then I'm going to use the cad orange. Why would you use the cad orange? Because it's a really good color. It's like glow-in-the-dark bright. Now I'm going to up to a slightly bigger brush again, which is this 8 bright. And I'm going to come get some just pure red pigment. I know, shocking.
You know.
Look at that pop.
Ooh.
Nothing quite like it. I'm leaving the purple there, but it's just, it's showing. You know
yeah.
what I'm saying? It's showing. Come over to this nose a little bit. Might get a smaller brush. I want some control.
Yeah.
And so I'm going to grab some just pure red here as well. And up under the lip. Under this nostril.
This painting definitely needs more cowbell.
What was that from?
Saturday Night Live.
Yes, that's right.
And unfortunately, I can't play any of the Blue Oyster Cult songs.
No, because that would totally like Blue
Content
Oyster
ID.
Cult would be making all money off my colorful cow, and I like them, but not that much.
Did you know, like back in like I think it was 1997 or something, I actually called them up and talked to the band directly because I wanted to put their music in a video game. They're like, "Yeah, that'd be really cool."
Really?
It was like we were living in Hockley at the time. To give you an idea, when I talked to them, so it was like a long, long time ago.
That is crazy. Rinse, 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 rinse. Now I'm going to do some kind of bananas. I'm going to take a little of my white over to my quinacridone. If you don't have quinacridone, guess what? You could probably just use the red you have. It's just this is a very vibrant color, and so you want to use those in your mixes so that they have the most possible pop. And you can see that's got a lot of pop.
Yeah, that's a really, really a nice pink.
Yeah. It just shows up as what it is. So you want it, and if you can do it, do it. If you have it in your arsenal, use it. But if not, just go ahead and use your whatever red you have and white to make your pink. The big thing is a complete painting always wins. So don't worry about the little stuff. You're just going to want to be able to complete your painting and not be worried about that. So a cool thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to take a little of my black paint. I'm going to bring it up to my ears now. I'm going to kind of work this in the ears.
Oops.
See, by having the blue underneath, it's okay if some of my under canvas shows through my black paint. It's an interesting side effect.
I'm going to say...
Doing the same thing here.
That's pretty cool.
It's just cool. It's super cool, man.
Now, we have a steady stream of Australians wishing us well out there. And for Dreamweaver, you know, Cinnamon and I would so come down to Australia and just, like, do this if we had the chance with you guys. So,
oh, yeah.
You know, as soon as we get the chance, we're going to go on tour and come paint with everybody all around the world. But we will specifically be coming down under.
Yeah, I think so.
Absolutely.
I'm going to make a point of not taking this to my eyeball.
Oh, you have to adjust the close-up camera.
Okay. So the trick is here, when you put some black over here, don't take it to your eyeball. You're going to come back with some orange later. Don't take it to your eyeball. Just do a little scrumble here. You just want to create some pop. So all you're doing is you're creating some pop interest to what you've got going on. See the pop?
Mm-hmm. Now, I bet you this cow's milkshake brings all the boys to the yard.
I'm going to sippy sippy on that note. We did it a long time, too, before we got married, so I knew.
She knew. She knew better.
I knew. We did a lot of dating.
But see, look, now what she gets for that...
Is I get my best friend helping me make these videos.
I make fun of her with lower thirds and all sorts of things like that.
That's dirty. I'm needing some new water soon.
New water?
So, yeah, I'm sorry. How's she looking? Is she starting to be just ultra fabulous? We're about to completely flood the feeds. You want to just take that cup and refill it? Here, grab this one. You just shake them out. Really, really on pop art pieces that have super bright colors. Besides going pure pigment over darker mixed tones, keeping that water clean. Sometimes it doesn't matter. Sometimes you're doing a piece where honestly the water being kind of dirty doesn't impact you or affect you. This chicken feather thing. Doesn't impact or affect you, but sometimes it does. Oh, I get to show you something. Oh, here it is. So we got a hat, and I had wanted to wear it today, but it wouldn't work with the earphones. It was like this crazy thing. It wouldn't go, but I just want to show you all this. We're trying to figure out how to get my earphones to sit nice so I can show that off soon, I hope. I'm just waiting for John to come back with water. Don't click away. We'll be right back painting. These moments are so pro. Hey, QVC. So ready for anything. Come back with water. But that is a tip from me to you, is when doing pop art pieces or trying to create these sort of bright, expressive works of art, is to keep that water clean and do brighter pop pigments over lower colors. So I'm going to work some green here. Now listen, if you don't have phthalo green and cad yellow, of course, you could just mix, you know, yellow and blue, which makes green. But because we're using these pure pigments, I can get this very, very vibrant color, adding a little white to it. I can come up here on the jaw. I'm really loving this cow. And make this really gorgeous. little run of color here. Isn't this a gorgeous run of color?
Yeah, my mic was off. Yeah, it really is.
Just fantastic. I love it. I'm loving this cow. I just find this, for all the energy in this piece and all of the crazy that it is, for me, is so relaxing. I've taken, oh, let me show you what I've done. I add a little more white to my green. And then I'm going to come up here to just this ear. Pull that down. See that? Come over to this ear.
There you go.
And put a little bit of that there. So it's still green. Still green. We still want green. And then I'm going to, almost two whole hands between these eyes, I'm going to take a little green. And I'm going to just add a little bit of that right here. Just a little kidney of that right there. Because I want, and what it is that I'm doing, if you're wondering, why am I making that decision or why am I doing that there? When I move these colors around and put them in a couple locations, it creates balance in the painting and centers it and makes it feel really good. That's why we do what we do. That's why we do what we do. I don't know why I'm such a weird man. Just
it's okay.
Crazy place. Now I'm going to grab just a little green here. Maybe I'm going to come and put a little bit right there. Just the pure green. I'll come back and visit that in a little bit. Come here, get a little white. Mm-hmm. Makes that crazy kind of mint color. I'm going to make a little line right here. And maybe it's going to come around here.
You need to pull the camera down a little
bit. Yeah, it comes around her little nose. Right? And then you're going to pull a little bit right here. Look at that. Pop of mint. Isn't that strong? Isn't mm-hmm. that amazing? Now I can take a little bit of this across to this side. Look at that. Took a little across. This sort of 1980s turquoise. This is sort of like an 80s cow.
Yeah.
I'm going to come to this lower end and curl that. See? Those balances. So this piece feels like it's completely out of control, but actually there's this whole, like, crazy bit of planning that goes into it. Now I'm going to come over here. And I'm going to add a little bit there. Look at that. Oh, so cool. So cool.
Yeah.
There you go. Just maybe a little bit there. It's just about finding these little spots and popping in those colors. Now, you can mix cad yellow and cad red to get orange, but there's this other color called cad orange. And they do have it in student-grade paints, mid-grade paints, all the way up to pro paints. This is real cad orange, and it's on another level. And I like to use it where it's appropriate. I don't really have a lot of opportunity. I'm going to come over here to the ear to use my cad orange as much as I would like necessarily on our show. And again, you can mix yellow and red to get an orange. So you don't have to go out and buy colors. You could probably find a close approximation like mm-hmm. in Deco Arts or Plaid as a neon orange. But it's just a very powerful color.
Oh, yeah.
Right? And it just creates this sort of, I'm going to come up here. Like that. Make that little sort of calligraphy mark. Right? Calligraphy marks are great. I'm going to come down into this part of the face. Let me make sure you can see that. I'm just going to pop some of this. Look at that way this orange against this purple and this green plays.
Mm.
It's crazy, right?
Yeah.
It's crazy.
That's awesome.
I loves it.
So we have another little brush Nemo with us.
Really?
Yeah. So we have lots of little brushes join us. So I thought we'd say hello.
So I'm going to make little orange marks under the chin here. A little orange. Isn't that strong?
Mm-hmm.
It's shocking, right?
That's awesome.
Oh. It's just so awesome. It's just like this cow like starts to come together. This cow's like, she's like, I'm having a good cow day.
Good cow day.
It's a good cow day. For me, the cow. So I'm going to come along this little brow bone and pop a little run of orange.
Mm-hmm.
Take it down and then around that. Look at that.
There.
Cool. I just love doing this. I love doing this style. I don't know how popular it is in the world, but I was surprised so many people wanted a colorful cow.
You have to get you adjust your close-up here a little bit more.
Okay. I love that you guys wanted to do a colorful cow like this.
It's like pop art colorful cow.
It is.
It's like pop art crazy colorful cow who could have a hat.
She could. You really feel that hat. I can tell because you're like, the hat. There could be a hat.
You put your hat, hat on that cow.
There's no hat, but you know.
It just is a Sherpa-like cow who could have a hat.
She could. Now, this is a crazy little move I took, but I felt it. You know, you could do just white up here or whatever, but I really felt that the top of this needed to be this sort of orange. What's nice about this particular cad is that it really has good coverage. So there we go.
Now, does this kind of does this style of painting have a particular or a real name? I mean, is this considered pop art?
This is definitely deep in pop art.
This is like a pop art painting.
Yeah, now, this is deep in pop art. I mixed a little of my cad orange to my cad yellow. I'm gonna come pull some white into it. See. Getting almost like this bright sherbet. I'm going to come under here and around the eye. All right. And I'm going to, remember how I said I was going to save that space for this other color?
Oh, yeah.
So this is that other color we're going to go into. Right around here.
Now, what is the name of the artist who did all the dots? He painted the dots in there like it was a comic book?
Oh, you mean Lichtenstein?
Is that Lichtenstein?
Yeah.
Okay. So I'm horrible with the names, but yeah, that's...
This is definitely
very
Lichtenstein. I mean, would they talk to me in the co-op if I was young and going to the clubs? Sure. I could rock some paint. I could have hung out with the pops.
Yeah.
Could have totally. I've got the same yellow down here. And I'm going to add some of this into this forelock up here. Just a little bit.
Oh, that's cool.
Just a little bit. Come grab some white if you need to.
Everybody's loving the pop art. They'd love to see more of this.
Yeah. Fun stuff, right?
Yeah.
Fun stuff. Simple stuff, fun stuff, doable stuff.
It's kind of a sherbet color.
It's kind of a sherbet color.
It's really cool.
Right? And now, because you've done that, you can come back with some red, because your ears are now dry.
Oh, get close up.
Get my close up. Thank you always for being there for me for that. I'm much better at doing this YouTube thing for you being here, babe. I'm going to come in the upper part of the ear. Pull a little bit down. Pure pigment, pulling it down. Look at that. It's pure pigment. We're working it.
See, the color is closer now than it was earlier because...
Put this bright red there. Okay, so then we're going to remember we got to hold the space to chuck, and we still need to put some of our yellow orange up in here. So we'll have to mix that again. And I think I'm getting to almost another space I have to change water, and that's how often you have to change water like a lot.
Do you need to get some more of that?
No, because I've got these here. I'm all good. So I'm going to put on a little more white for cap I've lost.
We'll get it.
We'll get it. And I'm going to make some more of this really bright pink, but you could just mix your cad red. Like we determined earlier, that would be okay.
Mm-hmm.
If you did this piece quite large, people would be like blown away. So I'm going to put another little bit of this pink down the nose.
Yeah, and it was Roy Lichtenstein that I was thinking of. For all of you guys who wanted to go kind of check that out, if you want to Google it, he's a pop artist from the 60s that
really cool
drew comic book style paintings. And it's really, you know, sort of a high art in there, and it's really cool.
It's just awesome. Truly, truly. Truly, 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 truly. So we have this right here. Now I'm going to take a little white and yellow. If I have any clean yellow left, dig out my clean yellow. Come over to my white. And right here, I'm going to talk about the highlight on the nose. Let me get the close-up camera down here.
Yeah.
So there's these highlights on cow noses. And whether you're doing this in pop art or whether you're doing this, you know, in realistic style, you got to pay attention to those parts. You got to still talk about where the reflections are on the piece. The piece still needs it. Put out a little more of the orange.
So, let's see here. I think it was Patricia was having some trouble. She was saying that... Why is this so hard for her? I have a lot of trouble with this style.
Oh, it's
hard.
I
love it, but my brain is fried trying to do it.
It's hard. Patricia, this is like you sat down and said to yourself, you know, I'm going to do some quantum physics today. Just for fun. Or like, you know, the New York crossword without like any Google. It's just, it is hard. And it's okay for you to be like, well, this is a stretch. What you've got to do is you've got to kind of take it from the places that are probably our little brushes are taking it from right now, which is that color is fun and shape is fun. And the experience you have creating something is intrinsically more important than the finished result. And by taking on projects like this that are challenging the way this is, where we're like, hey, let's just take away all of the safety net that our left brain has given us and let's go fly completely without guidance in our right brain, it's always going to create some distress inside of us.
Mm-hmm.
Like I said, I didn't get to this cow right off. It's unusual for me. Usually I'm like, paint it, nail it.
Yeah.
Right? And I had to do a couple cow designs because these are challenging. Then I had to be like, what could I share with everybody that would be really good for them? And I really had to think about that. And I'm going to come up here in this year. So don't be like, oh, this is hard.
And if I could add to that for you, you know, I've noticed that it took you a while to have a vocabulary with your brush, you know, to be able to say all these different things, like to know where that little checky kind of stuff goes and where to put your little squiggly dash. That just seems to come from painting a lot.
It really does. And it's still, John can tell you, I was like in here just like, oh, I got to get this. And you know, trying to find the space. I'm just coming with that orange and lining those shapes.
Yeah.
Just to ground them.
You know, the nice thing about doing these kinds of paintings with Cinnamon is she's worked out a lot of these design elements. So you can come in and start to learn about, like, where the checks go and understand how those checks can be laid in and then be able to take that to your other work.
Yeah. Like, and I'll always talk about, like, what was going on in my mind when I was, like, designing it. Like, I had to balance the check here with the check here. And since I'm doing check in this year, I have to do it over in that year. Kind of, like, things I know to create balance in the piece.
Yeah. And, you know,
I'm going to give him some outline.
You get a close-up there on that.
Yeah. I'm going to give him some outline. It's a little phthalo blue and a little white. Right, little phthalo blue and a little white. It's going to come around here.
Mm-hmm. Casey's like, every animal in the world pop art style. Now, please.
It's fun, isn't it?
It is.
It's so relaxing and it's so restorative. Yes, you know, her, you know, saying that's stressful, but it's also relaxing. If you just try to get into seeing each segment and taking it down and knowing what you're doing, it really does start to then just start unplug you.
Mm-hmm. Judgment chicken and crazy cow.
Judgment chicken and crazy cow. All my paintings have a secret name.
They do.
And I like their secret names. So I'm pulling this here. You can kind of see that I'm doing this. Right, so we're creating these little spaces, and maybe I'm going to come here. You know, and now I'm really winding up, interestingly enough.
I know, it's cool.
I'm going to put some Just True Blue inside my little nostrils here.
Oh, can you get close up on that?
So it'll be hard for you to see on the camera, but at home you'll be like, ooh.
Oh, no, you can really see the little bit in there.
Yeah, it just makes a difference, and it really is like, I know what I'm doing, and I finished my work.
Mm-hmm.
This is really fun to be able to bring this someplace, and people are like, oh, she knows what she's doing, and she finished her work. It's a good feeling.
Yeah.
It's a good, good, good feeling. I'm going to take some of this pure blue, come underneath the nose here. Right, just making sure that I have, I'm going to put a little here, that I have these enforcements. Right, now, I think I'm going to grab this nice big brush, which is a number 8 bright. And what I'm doing is I'm just trying to avoid dirty water is really what it is.
Should I get you some clean water?
No, I have some over here.
Okay. Ooh, Pop Art Bulldog.
Pop Art Bulldog would be great. There was some new dogs just put up on Paint My Photo that I'm super excited about. This mm-hmm. was just Thalo Blue. And the white. Just.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. And I'm going to keep just adding white and going in the piece. So I've got a little bit of that dark blue there. But now I'm going to get this white. And I'm going to come here.
You're going to go right off my camera.
Okay. So my paint is thick. Look at the bead on this piece.
That's a lot of paint.
Yeah, because I'm almost using my brush like a palette knife. Other reason that I like to have a firm filament bristle.
Is it impasto?
This is impasto.
Hey, look. I called it.
You did.
I'm learning some.
You learned it good. So we're coming around here, and we're just dropping these big chunks of white into our space. It's okay if a little blue gets into it. It's okay if a little of the other paint picks up on it. Right? That's not going to hurt us. We're just coming down here. But you can see how the paint underneath pulls through.
Yeah.
You cannot just do this on a white canvas. It does take the layers. I'm just coming around here.
Just painting around the cow.
Just painting around. See, that's just coming in really well. Look at that.
That looks really cool.
Okay. So we're letting that have a little dry because I'm going to want to rest my hand. I might like, and this is a good time to look and go, do I need, like I noticed in the original I put a pop of purple here. Some pops of purple.
Mm-hmm.
In there. You know, you might go like that. You just got to be like, what am I looking? What am I missing? What does it need?
Ooh, I would like, Autumn was suggesting, you know, a sloth.
A sloth would be great.
I like sloths.
John likes sloths quite a lot.
I like the giant sloths.
Grabbing another one of those small kind of quarter inch brights, mm-hmm. loading a bead, and I'm coming over to this ear. I'm going to bring the close-up cam is here for both ears, so that's great. I'm going to create that check pattern again.
It's a weird thing. I like giant sloths. That's a weird thing to like, I guess.
No, that's an awesome thing to like. They're so cool. They used to be like the size of a cow or something. Oh, no, that was
like
the lemurs.
Bears. No, they were the size of bears, like giant bears. Huge.
But you could outrun it.
And they were cuddly. I wouldn't cuddle one because they had talons the size of like...
A lot of things that are peaceful small would not be fun to cuddle big. You got to think about that a little bit, right? Coming over here to balance out. Creating a little check there. Isn't that fun?
Mm-hmm.
We're almost done, actually. Did you know that?
I think it looks pretty cool.
Yeah. He's looking pretty darn good. And then all he needs, I'm going to add a little water to my brush so it's not quite so thick on there. It's a little more fluid. And I'm going to come down into my eye. I'll zoom in a little bit and do each eye.
Ooh, zoomed in on that eye.
Yeah. Well, you know, you got to be able to see what I'm thinking here.
We're in there.
So I'm going to come along. I'm going to just very lightly define that.
So do you know how to paint horses?
Oh, yes. Do I know how to paint horses? Yes, very much. And I love painting horses. And I'm going to make a little light reflection. The paint's real thin. Mm-hmm. Right? Paint's real thin. So I'm going to just sort of shade this here. I'm using the thinness of the paint to create this instead of mixing a gray. You guys see that?
Yeah. Now, I have to say, I've never seen a pop art wombat. And that's coming. We've got a lot of requests for wombats.
No.
I'm not even pulling your leg. Yeah. It see here. Wombats have ticklish tummies. Is what I'm
is
not
this
even.
An I'll do
Janine
this for
says me. That.
Is this an Australian thing?
I'm pretty sure it's an Australian thing.
Not, couldn't go koala.
Yeah,
I think koalas are pests or something in Australia. I think like how we as Americans feel about koalas may not be how Australians feel about them. Kind of like, you know, how some of us feel about certain indigenous wildlife in Texas.
Yeah.
There is no cute fire ant, I got to tell you guys.
That's
so I've got a little bead of white.
That was an invading species that must burn.
Yes. So I'm just adding some little white lashes there.
Those are cow lashes.
They're little cow lashes. It's a nice touch. You just bring a little line there. I'm going to come here underneath the blue.
I can't see it. I can't see it.
Thank you.
There it goes.
Cow lash here. Isn't that cute?
Cow lash.
And just give it a little liner like that. Look at that.
That cow has been lashed.
Lashed. Oh, look at this cow. All right, so we zoom out. And one last little kind of dab of reflection that we might want to do.
Give that eye some gloss.
Just a little more gloss.
That's going to make your cow look all dewy-eyed.
Dewy cow. Oh, my goodness. Don't eat me. Don't eat me.
This is a forever cow.
This is a forever cow. That's right. He's a forever home.
Lives on Farmer Fleming's forever.
Forever farm. That's right. This is a Farmer Fleming cow. So, oh, my goodness. You guys have asked for him and her, and she was creative for you. I hope you love your colorful cow. I really love designing her for you. And, you know, whether you're, like, just sort of sitting into the color and relaxing, or whether you're like, this makes no sense, both journeys are really good for you. You know?
Oh, yeah.
So definitely, definitely do it. Before we go, do we need to take any questions?
Oh my gosh, there's
like just about the painting.
Well, no, there's a lot of people who are like have about 1,000 different animals that have come up, but surprisingly, we've had a lot of community answering our questions. We've had a pretty solid community out here with 230, 240 people. I mean, there's 232 out here right now.
Wow.
Yeah, just kind of give you an idea. We ended with 232 here.
And, wow.
So thank you guys for coming and hanging out with us. Everybody
absolutely
loves the cow.
Thank you for sharing on Facebook and Instagram and Twitter. I love your messages. Just so you know, there's something crazy with Facebook. Right now it's got new folders popping up, and I'm like having to find messages that, I don't know, they hide in new folders I haven't ever heard of before.
Yeah,
it's not even like the other folder. It's an other folder. It's like, what? This doesn't need to be any harder to locate. So if it's taking me a minute to respond, and then also some of them are just not, they're not coming up even when I search by name.
Yeah, we're so many comments and questions. Thank you, everyone. We really appreciate all of that. And, you know, we love you guys.
We do. You guys have a really good weekend.
Weekend.
And for every other day you're watching this. See you at the easel really soon.